story is true. That's first and foremost, story is true. And again, as you're hearing the story, I kind of want you to take a second at some point, even if right now or in a minute or two or half hour from now, to take a moment, close your eyes and kind of feel the muscles and engage with the muscles throughout your legs, right? Your lower body. So your calves, your hamstrings, your quads, your glutes, everything in your adductors, and feel the muscles and how they responded to the work that I presented to you today. Okay, feel how your body got stronger. Feel the way that your muscles worked hard, okay? That soreness is muscle tissue and muscle fiber literally tearing so that it can build back stronger than it did, than it was before. Okay, so that soreness is the muscle fibers tearing, but preparing themselves to build back stronger, and that's how we build our strength, all right? It's literally by tearing things down again, like I said before, break the mold, build it back stronger. It's an analogy for what our muscles are doing every day that we feel that soreness. It's breaking the mold, but it's always building back stronger because you're putting in that work, and you're making the effort, and you're giving your extra 1%, and you're not taking no for an answer, okay? Keep stepping through that door. So I'm just gonna pull up real quick the story that I'd like to tell you. Again, it is a true story. And I want you to kind of, if you know what I'm talking about part of the way in, you can, you know, you can smile to yourself. I won't be able to see, obviously, but you can smile to yourself. And at the end of the story, there's a couple morals that I'd like to, you know, to illustrate with you guys, because it relates exactly to what we're doing every single day. So this story takes place in the 1940s and is about a 65-year-old man, okay? A 65-year-old man living in Kentucky, okay? He was living off of his $99 a month checks of Social Security, okay? He was living in a small rundown house, and he was driving a very beat up old truck. Very beat up old truck, okay? It was when you kind of ran it. Okay? It sounded like it had bronchitis. So all those things. It came to a point one day where this man kind of took a step back, like I ask you to, you know, from time to time, took a look at his life and said to himself, I gotta make a change. I wanna do something to change my life, to realize, you know, more of my potential, because I don't believe that I'm tapping into my full potential. So what did he do? He started to think about what he had in his life that he could offer to others, how he could benefit the lives of others, what he could do. And as he's thinking day in, day out, took maybe a week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, he's racking his brain out. And the one constant he keeps coming back to is this chicken recipe, this fried chicken recipe that his friends and his family just absolutely love. Whenever they have parties or barbecues or things like that, cookouts, his friends and family are always reaching out to him, can you make the chicken recipe? Can you make your locally renowned chicken recipe? And he thinks, okay, let me see if I can spread that with the world, spread that love that people have with this chicken here, and see if we can take that out. So he decides to go across country again with that $99 Social Security check, that beat up old truck, leave that tiny house behind, and he starts going out, and he wants to change the world. He left Kentucky and he started traveling the country trying to sell this recipe to restaurants. The first one he went to, immediate no. Hey, that's okay. It's immediate no, it's fine. There's other doors, other fish in the sea, other restaurants. He got a second no, and a third one, and a 10th one, and a 100th one, a 500th one. He was told no 1,009 times. Literally, it's facts. 1,009 times he was told no, okay? And at the end of it, you know, from that 1,009th no, he was giving out the recipe for free. He was asking for, you know, a small chunk of the profits maybe, but he was giving out the recipe for free. He wasn't even selling the recipe itself. Okay, 1,009 times he said he was told no. He had a door that was closed in his face. No, thank you. I don't want any. Okay, but he remained persistent. He remained confident in his goal and his belief, and in his own drive and passion for what he had to offer. That hey, that 1,010th restaurant that he went to, they said yes. They said yes to his chicken recipe. They brought it into their restaurant. Okay, and that man's name. Okay, that guy who had that chicken recipe that went around and got told no 1,009 times before he got that one yes that changed his life, Colonel Hartland Sanders, Colonel Sanders. So that was the story of the origins of Kentucky Fried Chicken, which obviously a world-renowned, you know, nationally recognized chain. And his journey started by not one, not two doors slammed in his face, but 1,009 doors slammed in his face. Okay, coming from a $99 a month Social Security check, coming from a tiny rundown house in the heart of Kentucky, coming from a beat up old truck, okay, to world nationally recognized food chain. So aside from the non-compliance of it all, there's a couple messages that I want you guys to take away from the story. The first and foremost is that it is never too late to chase a dream. It is never too late to find, to discover, to experience success at a new level. It is never too late, okay? We have members here at the Max right now in our center that are seniors in high school at Harvard and Central, seniors in high school. Okay, we have members here who are in their late, mid to late 60s. Okay, we have a wide range of members here, wide range, genders, ages, backstories, races, ethnicities, okay, all, everything across the board. It is never too late for any single one of those people to find success. It is never too late. All you gotta do is put on a smile and have a dream up here, and we're gonna take care of the rest for you. We're gonna help give you the tools to find that success, okay? One step at a time. It is never too late. So get that stigma out of your mind right now. It is never too late to find that success. That's number one. Number two, how amazing is persistence, right? So you gotta stay persistent to get that goal, to achieve it. Because you might have one stumbling block along the way. You might find two roadblocks along the way. There might be a day where you're not feeling so great. You miss a class, and it's okay. There might be a day where, you know, someone in your house makes cake because they found the box in the back of the pantry and they decided to make it. It smells so good, and you have a piece, and it's okay. It's okay. Maybe it's your birthday and you have a piece of something. It's okay. Okay, we all have those times where we're kind of stepping to the side or stepping back instead of stepping forward. But that doesn't change the mindset here. That doesn't change your persistence, because every day you come right back at it and say, okay, now can I retake that step forward? Can I re-push myself just like I've been doing? Persistence is so key. You got to believe in yourself. Believe in what you have to offer, just like Colonel Sanders did. Believe in what you're giving out. Believe in the positivity that you're spreading to the rest of the world, okay? And there's absolutely nothing that can stand in your way. Because if you're persistent, there's no roadblock, there's no mountain, there's no ocean that's big or wide enough or deep enough that you can't traverse. Because you've already done it up here. You already have your goal up here. You already succeeded up here. That's more than half the battle. And now we just have to do it right here every day, which is exactly what you're doing. And that badge of honor now that says 34 days stronger, all right, you earned that. You earned that through hard work. You earned that through persistence and through chasing a dream and looking for that success. And I promise, you keep that frame of mind, you keep that march mentality, okay? We're gonna find that success together. So I want you to bring it in nice and close. I want you to put a fist in with me. We're gonna say, take it to the max, nice and three. I'm gonna go like this. Take it to the max, nice and three. Okay, that's your picture. If you wanna post it, it's for you. Okay, let's go. Take the max, nice and loud. Thank you guys for pushing with me. Again, cheesy, bringing it with me, okay? Honor system. One, two, three. Take it to the max. Have a great rest of your morning, afternoon, evening, whenever you're watching this. Thank you for working out with me. I will see you guys soon. Take care, and always take it to the max. Keep pushing, keep staying strong. You guys got this.